Been busy, which is good.
There's a lot going on. A lot going on for us fathers. Yeah, I'm just wondering how it was with you. You're like a newbie dad.
You know what? I feel like I have more of a balance than people realise. Sometimes people are consumed by the screen and think that everything that happens on the screen is only the thing that's happening.
How do you ensure that parental pressure is just as important as peer pressure? Because that's one of the biggest things that I found with the charity I run just around the corner from here, Void Youth, that peer pressure seems to be greater than parental pressure. And how do you get that balance right to ensure that you are saying something for the benefit and they recognize that and sometimes get at odds with their peers and them having to make the right sort of decisions?
Yeah, I think as they get older, I think it's more so about the foundation you're building, and while you have that kind of like pull in their lives, how much did you invest into that? Because no one could fight it. At some point, the peer pressure is going to become probably bigger than the parental or the family pressure. There's always been that pressure, but at some point it's going to feel for them bigger. It's just about at what point, whether that is age 8 or that is age 10, age 13 or age 16. But it's just going to happen at some point because, you know, peer pressure is a real thing. But I feel like, let's say like with my son right now, his pressure in a sense is family, is his parent, is the parent pressure. So while we've got that hold on him right now, the thing I always have to ask myself is, how much are we investing into him? Because what we could be doing is we could be letting the TV raise him, just go and watch something, or just go play iPad, or, you know, just go and just play in your room, you know, or just go outside, and we could be investing no time into him. So while this time which we have where he actually looks up to us as his everything, are we actually building connections with him? Because those are the things that will last and go on as he gets older, or which I understand, it just happens, you know, life is tiring, so it's just easier sometimes to be like, okay, go in front of the TV, go watch TV. It's easier to say, go outside and you know, and run, you know, just go to your room and play, it's easier. But I feel, because I know where I've grown up from, me and my wife have grown up differently. Like, my mum was a single parent, she was raising 4 boys by herself. She didn't have time, it wasn't a situation of choice. There was just no time. She was doing everything she could just to put food, and literally, just put food on a plate. Because you can say I'm present in my child's life. Externally, you can make everybody believe, you know, you're around. I'm always with my kids. But it's kind of like, you're present, but are you involved in your children's life? And I know there's a big difference, yeah. You know, and even I check, and it's something which I always have to check myself, because sometimes you can be around, but it's like, how involved? Like, am I talking to him? Have I asked him what exactly has he done today? What he wants to do? When he's having these silly jokes, am I just kind of like, oh, children being silly again? Or am I getting involved in that, you know? And I just know there's a big difference from being present to being involved.
Yeah, absolutely. No, exactly. I suppose that's covering or coming up to issues around, you know, absent fathers. You don't necessarily have to be on the same roof, but you have to be involved.
Yeah.
You can't allow yourself to be absent in all aspects of their life. The way in which we as black fathers will talk to our children and advise them and how to conduct themselves is culturally emphasized, and it'd be different to how a white person will say to their children, well, these are the sort of things you have to think about. And that sort of gets to the a thought around the talk. Even as a parent of 3 children, I had to really talk to my boys differently to my daughter, to say, listen, not only dealing with your peers, but understand how you deal with women and understand how you don't allow your values to impose on your relationship with young ladies and be overbearing with them and all that control and power business, you know? And that for me is something that, again, that talk. Is that a talk you have with them?
Well, my children are young, but I have had this conversation with my older son, where I've said to him, listen, like, example, so he's playing, he does a play fighting, all that stuff there, the other day in the park. He pushed a girl, a friend of his though, you know, and she was started crying and she was like, you know, I'm not your friend, this and that. And I was like, I didn't see the push though. I said, oh, why are you not Michaela's friend? Like, you pushed me, this and that. And I had to, you know, have this conversation with Michaela and say, look, you don't push girls, you know that. He said, and she said to me, no. I said, you know why? He said, no. I said, you know, you're not. And it's weird to say, because some people might question what means. I said, you're not the same. You know that, right? But you know, you don't push girls, you don't hit girls. Do you know that? And I had to explain to him. And also, he didn't fully even understand. He did, obviously, he knows boys, he knows girls, all those things there, right? But I had to explain to him, you don't hit girls. You do not ever put hands on girls. And I'm like, see the way you're playing with your boyfriends, your male friends? I said, that's fine, you're playing with them.
No one's an expert. Each child is different, because, you know, just like your two sons, one you can deal with in a certain way, and the other has a totally different feel, look and feel.